Hi, and welcome to part two. I am the Norwegian train driver, and today we are going to continue our journey towards Oslo from Roa. And to recap a bit, Hønefoss, which we left in part one, is here, and our current position is here. We are about to drive into Roa station, and we are turning right here and head for Oslo. Zooming into the station now, we are here and going in this direction. And to show you Gjøvikbanen, that goes up here. Before heading into Roa station here, I thought I'd explain this yellow sign under the main signal here saying FJS. That stands for Remotely Controlled Area. So there's a train leader or train dispatcher controlling the signals on the line. But you see the sign is scratched over here. That means that the station master controls the light and switches and such ahead of us. There's also a train coming from Gjøvikbanen. You see that over there. So who do you think is gonna drive first from Roa station? Downhill towards Roa, so I had to apply a fair amount of brakes. And the problem with freight trains, if you use too much brake, you use up the air, and it can take 1 to 2 minutes before the brakes release, so you can drive further. And apparently the station master thought I was using way too much time here, so he called me while we were standing here and asked if I had any trouble or what was happening. So I just told him I used up all my air and I have to wait some seconds before I can drive further. Okay, they're released now, so let's continue.
Yep, hi.
So let's go through today's stations while we wait for the passenger train. We are at Roa. We are going to pass Grua, Harestua, Stryken, Hakadal, Varingskollen, Åneby, Nittedal, Movatn, Snippen, Kjelsås, Nydalen, Grefsen, and Alnabru. And here comes the passenger train. Of course, we had to wait. So the next station from here is Grua. So when this train drives into Grua, then we're gonna have a green light. So the station master just called and given us permission to leave Roa station. So let's continue. So under the main signal here, you see the other type of the FJS sign. So this means we are driving into a remotely controlled area. And it's controlled by the train leader or train dispatch. flashing green and orange. You know what that means. That means reduce our speed to 40, and we're gonna go through the switch and probably meet another train here at Grua station. One green light, that means reduced speed, and the flashing orange means that it's red at the end of the station, so we have to stop and meet another train. In Sweden, the green lights is opposite. They have two green lights for reduced speed, and if it's one green light, they can just drive normal speed. Come on, green light. Nope. Okay, we have to meet another train here then. Fast forward to that one. Oh, I forgot to mention this station on the list. This is Jensrud station. It opened in 2013 and it's only for trains, no passengers. So you have to stop here. You see two green lights, so there is no switch. The train we are going to meet are going to use the switches.
Thank you.
So we have arrived at Alnabru. This is our largest station. It's 850 meters long. And it's kind of special because you don't see the neighbor track all through the station. We are going through a tunnel, and the other track is going around the tunnel. And you see a lot of green lights here to the right. They are called repeater signals. They are all green because we have a green light at the main signal. So here is one on the right side. There is also a green light in the tunnel. And a green light coming up ahead of us here. It looks like a main signal, but it's also a repeat signal. It says REP on it. So we just repeat what the main signal ahead of us is going to show.
Thank you.
So the Oslo border is between this tunnel opening and the switch here. So the upcoming station Movatn is the first station within the city limits.
Thank you.
We are approaching Kjelsås station now. I lived here in this building when I was studying to be a train driver. My mother also lived here when she was little. Not in that building though, but in the Kjelsås area. Approaching Grefsen station now, and we are going to leave Gjøvikbanen and head for Alnabru. So Gjøvikbanen is following a straight line here, and we are going on the track to the right, and we are going to cross Gjøvikbanen over that bridge you see here, and Gjøvikbanen is going to continue to Oslo Central Station. Let's zoom out so we can get a better view. You see Oslo Central Station to the right in the picture here. So Gjøvikbanen is going this way, and we are going this way towards Alnabru. So the subway is going to the right of us here. So there is a subway station coming up here to the right. Thank you. Hello, station master woman. So we are turning right here, as I showed you in Google Earth. And then we take the overpass over Gjøvikbanen.
Thank you.
So we are entering Alnabru now, the largest train yard in Norway. The long beep you heard, that was the automatic train control system shutting down. So there's no use for that in here. A while back, I had to wait here on Alnabru for a long time, and then I brought my drone, so I have a little clip for you if you want to see. I think there's something like 50 parallel tracks here. So I'm panning towards the direction we arrived from now. The left one here is going towards Oslo Central Station, and the right track here is where we came, towards Grefsen. All right, let's continue.
Thank you.
So this is it for this video. It's gonna be a two-parter because my last series, the five-parter called Freight Train through the Norwegian capital to Kongsvinger, we drive on the track to the left of us here. So if you wanna continue this journey, you can follow this link. And thanks a lot for joining. And please subscribe and ask question and leave a comment.